the other side also. Thank you. Run.
Ik dacht even mijn handen door.
moeten maar van. We moeten maar van.
This is a really rare collection of 3D battlefield photographs. To see this many is a real rare thing. Okay, they're a bit graphic for their battlefield photographs, but that's the reality. Come this way. So this actually is pre-war, that's pre-First World War either, that's identical
how it is today.
So I've got an 18th century, or a copy of an 18th century painting at home with Ypres Square, and you can look at it, and you can go, oh, that's that restaurant, that's right. So it's completely replicated. That's how it ends up at the end of the war. So that's the cloth
one. Oh my God.
Wow.
So when I say it's destroyed,
oh my God.
I mean that, because... No, the Germans also, if you notice, everything's destroyed. The cathedral behind, for example. But that stump of the tower still stands at the end of the war. And the reason for that is because the Germans on that ridge are high ground, they're overlooking Ypres. Even from the back of Tychot Cemetery, you can see right through to Ypres and see the spires. But they're ranging their guns on the remnants of that tower. Because by the end of April 1915, Ypres by law has been evacuated of civilians. Packed full of soldiers on their way to the front line on their way back. So by bombing shells and all that, they know they're hitting.
Is that unbelievable?
And that's where we are. I mean, that's where we are now, Hill 67. It's not a picture as high as Mrs. Army. But you see what I mean? Yeah. Everything's destroyed. Yeah. Oh.
I mean, these are the images you see.
Guys, time to go wander around. There's too much to see here, okay, in terms of the two rooms.
Yeah.
And when you wander around here, the artifacts as well, okay. So these are the empty shell cases. These are all shrapnel shells, for example. Different size shell cases as you go around. These tubes here, these are Livens projectors. They're a British trench mortar, okay. They would be buried in the ground, yeah?
The trenches
are original. So the soldiers call this place Sanctuary Wood because they were bringing the wounded back from the front line. So the front line was on the other side of the road. I mean, you've got two more defensive lines further back, the support line and the reserve line. So they're connected by communication trenches, what are called communication trenches. So the idea is you can work your way up through the communication trenches from the reserve line to the support line and to the front line, yeah? So there was a communication trench running right through here, and that's the entrance to it now, okay? Now, that trench is original. The actual trench itself is, some of the corrugated iron is and some isn't.
Mm-hmm.
Have you guys seen 1917, the film?
Yep.
Yeah. But when you see these films, particularly 1917 at the end, the trenches in the films tend to be quite wide, for example. And that's filming purposes. You know, they run a camera up there. And straight. The trenches in reality are like this, very narrow, and the tight right angle turns, they zigzag. And the reason for that is if you've got a straight trench, of course, somebody can jump in it and fire down the full length and kill everybody. Yeah.
Mm.
So that's the reason why they're tight and they zigzag like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but also the thing about it is, here also, if you come this way a bit, all of these trees have been replanted since the end of the war, but can you see the shattered tree stumps over there with the crosses on? You can see the power of the artillery, that's what's left of the original wood.
Yeah.
You know, the power of the artillery, they're just treated them like that. Because of the high water table, they can't dig down any further because water's going to come up. There would have been sandbags on the top to give it extra height, okay? So it would have had a height of about 8 feet.
So taller guys would have been protected as well as, you know, as much as everybody else. Yeah. Now in 1916, this comes to
the Germans attacked here. This is Canadian position. This is the Battle of Mount Sorel. Canadian mounted rifles are pushed back through these, from the front line, through these communication trenches, and they're fighting hand to hand with Germans in these very trenches in June 1916. So men were fighting and dying here in 1916. So what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to say to you, can I have an explore, have a walk through the trenches. If you find it's too wet, just get out and just walk from the top to have a look at it. They're quite extensive, they're quite a way back. Be wary of sharp edges and that kind of thing. Don't forget the two rooms of the museum.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I want to give you best use of your time, yeah? So it's now 20 past 10. If we could get out of here, let's say by what? 10 to 11, 11 o'clock, something like that. Should give you plenty of time, yeah?
Easy.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'll meet you in the cafe when you're done.
Beautiful.
Okay. Okay. Great. Great.
Wow.
This must be another, like, crater here,
another
too,
crater
probably.
Here. It looks like one out of it's just in here.
Thank you.
Okay. We gaan terug naar de bus. Om dan naar Prinsen te gaan. Down there now,
yeah, I know. I don't know how to get out. a little wet.
Okay. on the last of Christ.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yep, please.